In this video, the usually guided transporter does not follow a sequence. Guided transporter goes from source to destination, follows the defined route, and if there is more than several routes to get from source to destination, always pick the shortest one. But in this example, we followed like literally what we did, define a sequence, and it's gonna follow it like the way we wanted it. And how did we manage to do this? Is by using advanced transfer, or literally advanced process expression, and we define the station within the expression, as you would see here. So in case you have, I don't know, just like this column, all the station in it, and then by using this box, so you could say this is the alternative path, it's gonna get the value from, as you could see here, like how it's written, and the same here, how it is written the same way. So the transporter is not guided anymore, it just it follow a sequence defined by the user, and the sequence defined by the user, it just as you could see here, the second we stop this specific sequence, it will go back to normal as it was before, like it follows the tracks, we set the tracks to follow it, as you would see here. So now here, let's do an example. If we go to the it has to go station 3 and then it carry on to the blue station. So station 3 is this, that one here, the station 3 linked to intersection 3, and then it carry on to the blue station. So if we run the program, okay, it follow like, you know, as we wanted it to do. And if we go back to the advanced process to the expression again, and instead of 3 we write 4, for example, so you could see here when we do this, it's gonna follow that line here, okay, because we specified as a sequence. So in this way we managed to break the guided transporter, now it follow a defined sequence, okay. So if you want a copy of this program, please email me, it is in the box below. Thank you.